with you, everybody. Jimmy with Two of the Top Crane. Today we're in Lamoni, Iowa. Yesterday it was 60 degrees when we got here. Now it is 18. It was about 9 this morning, I think. That's Fahrenheit, so it's pretty chilly. It's cold enough I had trouble cleaning my glass. My glass cleaner was freezing when I sprayed it on the glass. But anyway, we thought we were going to need the jib on this job. Fortunately, the customer was measuring a little long when they ordered the crane. After Mike and I got here yesterday, we measured everything out. It looks like we're going to be able to set these units with main boom only. But we're going to be stretched out to about 164 feet. So we'll have full counterweights on the old Tadano 180G. And a full counterweight package is 110,000 pounds. But we'll have 110,000 pounds of counterweight, 186 feet of main boom, and we'll be running one part of line, I'm sure. And right now we're just waiting for our other truck to show up with counterweights. Got to be here anytime. Oh, he's here. We just got to get him backed in. So, yeah. And we got an awesome tree right behind us. When I say right behind us, I'm going to keep swinging a little bit. I'll pan this up. There it is. Anybody that's worked on colleges or universities in the United States knows that messing with the trees on campus is typically not allowed. We may have trimmed a few little limbs out of this with the crane when we were setting up, but they were pretty small twigs. May or may not have. I can neither confirm nor deny. But anyway, Kyle's getting backed in. We're going to get our other pieces of counterweight on and finish getting set up. We'll be ready to rock and roll.
Radius, so we're gonna get that back.
docks the other day. I thought on our range diagram would be boomed down further, but I guess with all the deflection, that makes a difference. Okay, cabling down easy. Set that unit at 160 feet. We're going to get rid of some of this boom because our next units are quite a bit closer. Let's see, how far can we go out? We're going to knock this thing down to 157 feet. So that just means pulling in section number one all the way. That'll leave section 5, 4, 3, and 2 at 93%. That way we can still grab that unit over there. I can go out to 144 feet with that. So, yeah, let's do that. Boom mode number 9. So we're going to switch our screen, move my phone into our boom modes. Get the charts back out of the way and stand on the throttle, pull this stick back, should unpin right there, hopefully you can see that. So the center block went away, so now we're retracting section number one. That allow me to get these other units closer to me when I set them, but it should make things a little faster. Alright, section one's all the way in. It's gonna lock in place down below, and then the telescope cylinder here is gonna come out and pin in to section number two, and then it'll give me an okay. about where I need to be before I do a lot of swinging, because we're going to be in this tree a little bit with the jib. Comes with all the responsibility, but it also comes with the comfort of having a heated seat and a heater. Which right now doesn't upset me. Instead of booming down, I'll probably just let the deflection take it. I'll just let it pull me down to about 129 feet, and then I'll just start booming up with it from there, cabling up and booming up.
this camera. I need to fix this. The end of this bolt stripped out, so I can't tighten it down. It might stay put there, but I still can't see much. And here pretty soon, I should have the Tadano sticker put right there. Yes, sir. Swinging left. let them cut me loose, swing around, get rid of all of that, get rid of 110,000 pounds of counterweight, go get in the dolly and head home. Step one.
Let's turn this heat down.
Also, I get asked a lot what manufacturer I prefer as far as, you know, Tadano, Liebherr, Grove, Link Belt. And I gotta say, I'm pretty partial to these Tadanos. Great machines. Great machines with excellent product support.